Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studio. Thanks for watching. I love doing videos about goalies. I think most hockey fans enjoy watching great saves. Even if it's against your team, you appreciate when a goalie stands on his head. At the draft, goalies seem to be ranked a lot lower than skaters. The position is unique. Can't really evaluate a goalie against a skater. And there's really only a couple of jobs out there available. And a lot of the time when a team has rolled the dice and gone for a high prospect, they've gone for a hotshot goalie with a high pick, it's bombed on them. You see, a lot of the time goalies are found late in the draft. And I think it's because they just simply develop a lot slower than skaters. Personally, I don't even like where the draft age is. I think it should be 20, not 18, but that's for another video. What I'm doing in this video is I'm going to rank the best goalie per draft class, going all the way back to 1979. Now, the NHL draft started in 1963, but it was not as strong back then. Teams didn't even put a lot of weight into it, and a lot of teams passed. They just felt there wasn't anyone available out there. And so they would go through rounds and maybe one team or two teams would pick in the fourth or fifth round. And it was just not as strong. It wasn't as organized as it is. As it went on, now a lot of emphasis came on the draft and teams began to realize how important draft picks were. As I looked through the draft, I saw that beginning in 1979, this is where teams never passed after this point, that they went through all the rounds, they took all their selections, you could see what an important part it was. Now, when I'm looking at these drafts, I'm going to go from 1979 up till 2012, because, again, looking in my research, I thought that after 2012, the goalies hadn't played enough to give it a proper evaluation. So I'm just gonna go from 1979 all the way to 2012. I'm going to tell you who the best goalie from each draft class was. Rick Walmsley was drafted 58th overall by Montreal. Walmsley went on to play over 400 NHL games for four teams. He won a Jennings in 1982 and a Stanley Cup with the Flames in 1989. Andy Moog was drafted 132nd overall by Edmonton. Moog played over 700 NHL games for four teams. He won the Stanley Cup in Edmonton three times. Moog was a top five finalist for the Vezina Award four times. He won the Jennings in 1990 with Boston. In 92-93, Moog won a career-high 37 games. John Van Beesbrouck was drafted 72nd overall by the New York Rangers. Van Beesbrouck played over 900 NHL games for five teams. The Beezer won the Vezina in 86 and was runner-up in 94. Some of you may say, where's Grant? I chose Van Beesbrouck over Fuhr here because John had a better career goals against and save percentage. Ron Hextall was drafted 119th overall by Philadelphia. Hextall played over 600 NHL games for three teams, but a huge chunk of that was played in Philly. Ronnie won over 30 games in a season five times. He won the 87 Vezina and Conn Smythe, becoming just the third player ever to win playoff MVP for a losing team. Dominic Hasek was drafted 199th overall by Chicago. Hasek played over 700 NHL games for four teams. During an inhuman eight-year period, Hasek was a finalist for the Hart Trophy five times, winning it twice. He won the Vezina six times, the Jennings twice, was a six-time All-Star. In 2002, Hasek won 41 games and won his first Stanley Cup. In 1989, Hasek barely allowed a goal, and the Czech Republic won the Olympic gold. In 2011, the Hockey News called Hasek the fifth best goalie of all time. Patrick Waugh was drafted 51st overall by Montreal. Waugh played over 1,000 NHL games between Montreal and Colorado. He was amazing. Waugh won four Stanley Cups and was playoff MVP for three of them. During the regular season, Waugh was a six-time All-Star. Five times he won the Jennings. Seven times Waugh was a finalist for the Vezina and he won it three times. When he retired, he was the NHL's all-time wins leader. In 2011, the Hockey News called Waugh the second greatest goalie of all time. Mike Richter was drafted 28th overall by the New York Rangers. Richter played all 742 of his NHL career games with the Rangers. He won a career-high 42 games in 93-94, plus the Stanley Cup that spring. Twice, Richter was a top five finalist for the Vezina, but he was named MVP of the World Cup in 96 and won a silver medal at the O2 Olympics. Ron Tugnutt was drafted 81st overall by Quebec. Tugnutt played over 500 NHL games for eight clubs. Whoa! He was a late bloomer because his best seasons came in his 30s. In 98-99, Tugnutt led the NHL with a 1.97 goals against. He was the Blue Jackets' first ever goalie and got 22 wins that first year in Columbus. Guy Hébert was drafted 159th overall by St. Louis. Hébert played just under 500 NHL games for three teams. He was the first goalie for the Mighty Ducks and played 8 years there, winning a career-high 31 games in 98-99. Stéphane Fissé was drafted 24th overall by Quebec. Fissé played nearly 400 NHL games for four teams. In 96, Fissé won the Stanley Cup in Colorado. As a member of the Kings, he played a career-high 60 games during the 98-99 campaign. Olof Kolzig was drafted 19th overall by Washington. Kolzig played 756 of his 764 career NHL games with the Capitals. He won over 30 games five times, including his 41-win season in 99-2000, the same year he won the Vezina. His 9.41 save percentage during the 98 playoffs when Washington went to the finals was the best in the league. Martin Brodeur was drafted 20th overall by New Jersey. Brodeur played nearly 1,300 NHL games, all of seven of them with the Devils. He is the NHL all-time leader in games played, wins, and shutouts. Brodeur won three Stanley Cups, was a seven-time All-Star, won the 94 Calder. Nine times he was a finalist for the Vezina, and he won it four times, along with five Jennings. Internationally, Brodeur won two gold medals at the Olympics. In 2011, the Hockey News called Martin Brodeur the third best goalie in NHL history. Chris Osgood was drafted 54th overall by Detroit. Osgood played over 700 NHL games, most of it with the Red Wings. Six times, Osgood won over 30 games, including a career-best 39 in 95-96. He helped Detroit to three Stanley Cups and won two Jennings. He is one of just 13 goalies in NHL history with over 400 wins. Nikolai Habibulin was drafted 204th overall by Winnipeg. Habibulin played over 800 NHL games for four teams. The Bulin Wall won over 30 games four times. In 2004, he backstopped Tampa to the Stanley Cup. Tommy Salo, drafted 118th overall by the New York Islanders. Salo played over 500 NHL games for three teams. Although he only won over 30 games twice, he spent most of his career in either Edmonton or Long Island, so the odds were against him. But Salo was a Team Sweden staple for many years, winning six medals at the World Hockey Championships. Evgeny Nabokov was drafted 219th overall by San Jose. Nabokov played over 700 NHL games for three teams. He won over 30 games in a season six times, including three 40-win seasons with a career-high 46 in 07-08. Nabby was the 2001 Rookie of the Year, and five times he was a top five finalist for the Vezina. Mika Kiprusoff was drafted 116th overall by San Jose. Kiprusoff played over 600 NHL games, but only 47 of them with the team that drafted him. Kipper was dynamite in Calgary for years, averaging 39 wins a year for a seven-year stretch there. He was a three-time finalist for the Vezina, winning it in 2006. 95 was a tough year to pick. Jean-Sébastien Giguère had a great career too, but I chose to go with Kipper. I'll give this one my best French. Mathieu Garon, was that pretty good? Drafted 44th overall by Montreal. I really can't do any better than that. Of the 22 goalies drafted in 1996, only two went on to have NHL careers, and the other one was Robert Esch. Garon played over 300 NHL games for six teams. He played a career-high 63 games in the Kings' net during 05-06. In 2009, he won a Stanley Cup in Pittsburgh. Roberto Luongo was drafted 4th overall by the Islanders. Luongo has had a great, Hall of Fame-worthy career, playing over 1,000 games for three teams. As of 2018, he's 3rd all-time in games played and 4th in wins, but Lou is just behind Eddie the Eagle there and will almost certainly catch him. Roberto is a 3-time finalist for the Vezina and a 2-time All-Star. Andrew Raycroft was drafted 135th overall by Boston. Raycroft played just under 300 NHL games for three teams. He won the Calder in 2004 and played a career-high 72 games for the Maple Leafs in 06-07. Ryan Miller was drafted 138th overall by Buffalo. Miller has had a good NHL career, playing close to 800 NHL games for four teams. He's won over 30 games seven times, including a career-high 41 in 2009-10. It's the same year he won the Vezina. Ryan Miller is in the top 20 for all-time wins. Henrik Lundqvist, drafted 205th overall by the New York Rangers. Lundqvist will be in the Hall of Fame someday because of his spectacular career. The King has a real good chance of becoming just the third goalie in NHL history to reach 500 career wins. He's averaging 34 wins a year, and seven times Lundqvist has been a top five finalist for the Vezina, winning it in 2012. Mike Smith was drafted 161st overall by Dallas. This was a real close call between Smith and Craig Anderson, but I chose to go with Smith. He's played over 500 NHL games for four teams, but he's been stuck on a lousy team for most, if not his entire career. Smith has averaged just 18 wins a year because of that. Despite this, his career goals against is still better than Anderson's. Cam Ward was drafted 25th overall by Carolina. Ward has played his entire 700-plus game career with the Hurricanes. Wardo took home the 2006 Stanley Cup and Conn Smythe. He's won over 30 games five times, including a career-best 39 in 08-09. Marc-Andre Fleury was drafted first overall by Pittsburgh. Safe to say, Fleury has lived up to his draft position. With over 400 career wins and three Stanley Cups, Flower has been great for many years. He has eight 30-win seasons, including a career-high 42 in 2011-12. Pekka Rinne was drafted 258th overall by Nashville, perhaps the greatest draft steal in history. Rinne has been a wall in Nashville for many years. He's played over 600 games, all of them as a Predator. As of 2018, he has seven 30-win seasons, three of them are 40-win seasons. Four times in his career, Rinne has been a Vezina finalist. Carey Price was drafted 5th overall by Montreal. Already the third winningest goalie in the long history of the Canadiens, Price has proven himself to be one of the best ever. He has four 30-win seasons, including 44 wins in 2014-15, the same year he won the Hart, Pearson, and Vezina. Steve Mason was drafted 69th overall by Columbus. The 2009 Rookie of the Year leads his draft class in games played and wins by a large margin. Twice, he's won over 30 games in a season. Scott Darling was drafted 153rd overall by Arizona. Darling is the only guy of the 20 goalies drafted in 2007 to have an NHL career, so he wins by default. He went 18-5-5 in 2016-17. Braden Holtby was drafted 93rd overall by Washington. Good Saskatchewan boy, already has three 40-win seasons. His 48 wins in 2015-16 tied an NHL single-season record. He won the Vezina that year and then finished runner-up for the award in 2017. Robin Lehner was drafted 46th overall by Ottawa. The Swedish netminder has an above-average save percentage despite playing most of his career in Buffalo, so it's not bad at all. Lehner is the only goalie from his draft class to play over 200 games. Frederik Andersen was drafted 187th overall by Carolina. Andersen has won over 60% of his starts during his career between Anaheim and Toronto, thanks to three 30-win seasons already. John Gibson was drafted 39th overall by Anaheim. Gibson is the only goalie of his draft class with over 50 games played, and he's already got over 200. The Ducks goalies should be a Vezina candidate for many years to come. Matt Murray was drafted 83rd overall by Pittsburgh. The 2015 AHL Goalie of the Year doesn't even have 200 NHL games under his belt, but he's got two Stanley Cups. He was good enough to take Fleury's job, and the Penguins are betting on Murray being one of the best in the world for the next decade. Like I stated at the beginning of the video, a lot of goalies taken late rounds. How many goalies that were the best of their class were drafted 100th or later? A lot of them. Some guys even down in the 200s. Henrik Lundqvist, Pekka Rinne, way down in the draft. Some draft years produced more than one great goalie. Mika Kiprusoff, Jean-Sébastien Giguère, really close. Both were award winners. Giguère came away with a Stanley Cup in his career. But Kiprusoff was really the backbone to the Calgary Flames there for 7 years. Remember how many games Mike Keenan played him? He was playing tons of hockey. Couple years there, weren't nearly as strong. Matthew Guerin, not a really good strong draft class. Scott Darling, as I said in the video, he's the only goalie really to consider. Hopefully he bounces back and is able to have a good career with Carolina. And then there's probably the one you guys are going to ask me the most about, JVB or Grant Fuhr. I'm not a huge Grant Fuhr supporter. When I track his numbers against other 80s goalies and put it on an even playing field, his numbers are significantly less than other goalies who played during the exact same period. I'm not saying Grant Fuhr was a bad goalie, I just don't think that he should be among the very best when people think about goaltenders. To me, Grant Fuhr is a lot like Chris Osgood. Great numbers, won a lot of Stanley Cups, won over 400 games, great numbers in that regard, but if you stack him up, if you put Grant Fuhr against his contemporaries, you put Chris Osgood against his, they're just not the same. They're not the high-end superstar goalie. I'd like to know what you guys think of this video. Did you find it entertaining? Do you like to see things like this? I enjoy blending the history in with my videos. I think it's a lot of fun. And of course, I love doing videos about goalies. Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.